Thank you for joining the CS Board video about StyleDrop, a new paper from Google Research that presents a novel method that directs text-to-image generation models to follow a specific style. For example, in this image we see at the bottom left an image that is used as a style reference. Then, using the prompt, a logo with letters StyleDrop in watercolor painting style, the model generates this image, which clearly follows the style of the style reference image, which is very impressive. The goal of this video is to explain the paper by discussing why it is so interesting and explain what the researchers did to make it work. Let's start with a short motivation. Why this capability is important? Pre-trained text-to-image models such as DALL-E 2, Imagen, Stable Diffusion and more are able to generate amazing results given text prompts, like this avocado chair. However, it is hard to synthesize a specific style in generated images. Even though a lot of effort has been put into prompt engineering, a lot of styles are hard to describe with text. Also, approaches such as asking the model to use Van Gogh style as part of the prompt may also be problematic, since Van Gogh used multiple styles in his paintings, as we see here. So the model may either choose a Van Gogh style randomly or use some mix of them, but this may not be what we would want. So, with StyleDrop, we are able to use an image as a style reference, like this image of a person drawing in a smartphone, and then generate images with consistent style based on the style reference, such as this example's ear of different subjects with similar style. Extracting the style from only one or few images is really mind-blowing, so let's move on to talk about how they were able to do that. StyleDrop is built using three crucial components, which we will review now. First component is Muse, a text-to-image generation model which was presented by Google earlier this year. We will leave the full description of Muse to a different video, but worth mentioning that it is a transformer-based model, rather than the diffusion model, which is common in other top text-to-image generation models such as Stable Diffusion. The researchers found the transformer architecture is a better fit for learning fine-grained styles comparing to diffusion model, such as Google's Imagen and Stable Diffusion. As said, we won't dive deep into Muse here, but to provide some intuition about how Muse works, during training it observed pairs of text and image, such as this prompt of a cat looking at a dog, with the matching image, at different scales. It uses a text encoder to get embedding for the text prompt, and it trains two transformers, one base transformer which gets the image in low resolution after it has been randomly masked, and it learns to reconstruct the masked tokens using the text embedding. Second is a super resolution transformer, which gets the input with higher resolution, also randomly masked, and using the text embedding and the output from the base transformer, it learns to reconstruct the higher resolution input image. Then, in inference, it just gets a text prompt, without image input, in order to generate an image. The second key component in building StyleDrop is adapter tuning. This step is inspired by a paper about parameter-efficient fine-tuning, also known as PEFT. In this step, they take the large pre-trained Muse text-to-image transformer and a few style images, with text that separates content from style, like in this example which we already saw, with the text colorful flowers in watercolor painting style. So, the first part of the text is the content, and the second part of the text is the style, and possibly there are a few more text and image pairs. They then style-tune the model efficiently on these images using adapter tuning. By adapter tuning here, the meaning is that they only focus on a small part of the model and they add a new small amount of weights to that part. And this addition is called the adapter. The existing pre-trained model weights are frozen during this process and not changing at all. This learned adapter helps to direct the large model to use a specific design in the images it generates in inference time. Before moving on, if you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. The third key component in building StyleDrop is iterative training with feedback. So what the researchers observed is that using the model resulted from steps 1 and 2 can be suboptimal due to overfitting to the style reference images. For example, when they style-tuned using adapter learning over this style reference image, they have generated few images from the model and some of them were good, as these two examples of a cat and an apple. But some examples, such as these two examples of a chihuahua and a temple, contain content that is almost identical to the style reference image. As a result, they came up with the third step of iterative training with feedback, where they continue the style tuning training on generated images with their prompts, which their quality is good, such as these two examples with the red frame. But how do they know which images are of high quality? They came up with two approaches to do that. One is called CF, a shortcut for clip feedback. Clip is a model by OpenAI which connects text and images to one embedding space. So they take the prompt and the generated image and feed them to Clip. They get an embedding for the prompt and embedding for the image in Clip embedding space. If the embeddings are similar, then they count the generated image as good, as it means that the image and the text prompt grasp a similar meaning. And if the embeddings are not similar, then they count the generated image as not good, and they don't use it for the remaining training process. The second approach is called HF, which is a shortcut for human feedback, where instead of clip, a human determines what generated images are of high quality. They show that with human feedback method, the user gets a creative control and can determine attributes of the final design. For example, here the user chose to prefer images with sharp corners as the one in the upper left, and the final model generated the other three images with sharp corners. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.